I can do for now.
Okay, so pause it real quick.
Pause.
Don't look up. Do not look up.
I have just not. Don't worry. I haven't looked up. You're gonna be about 20 seconds behind me, as well.
Okay. No, I know, but that's life. So you wake up in this chamber, and a female voice, computer voice, comes over telling you that you're a test subject. So you start going through these tests, and the way the tests go is that you can go through these weird portals, hence the name of the game. One's blue, one's orange. So you start going through solving these puzzles, and the robotic voice is telling you you're doing a good job, or you're not doing a good job, whatever, and you're going through, and it's all nice, but then you start to notice something weird. There's sometimes, every once in a while, little glass-like windows looking through where you can see computers and chairs and little note things, and you're thinking that those should be for where scientists or people who are watching the test would watch the people going through the tests and make notes or say, like, oh, this person's doing good or bad. Well, unfortunately, there's no one there. It's just empty. And every time you see a window, you look in expecting to see someone, and there never is. So you keep going through these test chambers, and the computer is telling you that, you know what, if you do good on these test chambers, at the end, you're going to get some cake. So you're like, yes, I want cake.
Is that where the cake is a lie thing comes in?
Yes. So you're going through these chambers, and eventually you find, like, little hidey holes that must have been left by previous test subjects. You go in those little holes, and you find notes saying things like, the cake is a lie, or help me, or I can't get out. And you start to wonder, what is really going on in this test, on these tests? And the robotic voice keeps saying weird things, like, instead of saying a program name, it will say things like, congratulations, you did better than everyone in insert user's hometown here, as if it wasn't even programmed at all. Finally, you get to the end of the puzzles and you're all excited. You're gonna get your cake now. You get on a moving platform and the computer is congratulating you on doing a great job. You found your companion cube, which is a nice cube with a heart on it that was helping you until you had to burn it to a crisp to sacrifice to get to the next part of the test. You did a good job. You're the best. But then you start to realize that the end of the track is coming. And instead of cake, there seems to be a pit. As you get closer, you notice the pit kind of smells like smoke. And you realize you're being sent to a pit of flames. Thankfully, you've used the portal gun enough that you figure out that if you hit a wall, you can escape. And you use the portal gun to get out, and you're on in the secret behind the scenes of the laboratory. Now you're loose, and you're going through all the tunnels and trying to figure out what the hell is going on. The computer's still coming over the line saying, what's going on? Where are you? You can come back. We can have cake. Also, the computer's name is GLaDOS, you find out. And eventually, you get to a final room. You walk in, and there's a giant behemoth of a machine. It's GLaDOS. She used a crazy computer who went mad with AI and killed all the scientists by flooding the room with neurotoxin. You start to fight her by using your portals to take the rocket launcher she's firing at you and redirect them back at her core. She starts breaking apart, losing personality cubes. You take them, or spheres, you take them and start throwing them into an incinerator, just like she made you do to your beautiful companion cube friend. How could she? It was horrible. So you finally throw all her cubes and she starts to self-destruct. Unfortunately, you can't get away. The roof blows open and you're sucked in with a vortex out into the outdoors. You white out. Suddenly.
Are you reading something when you're saying this?
No. No, I'm making this up as I go. Like, not making it up. I played the game, but... As you come back to consciousness, you're too weak to move. Debris is falling all over a parking lot. You're outside! You can see the gate to get outside. There's a forest. You think you see a deer, but you can't be sure. But suddenly, you hear a voice saying, thank you for taking the compliant something position to submit. Suddenly, you start getting dragged back against your will. Back into the laboratory. The end. That was Portal 1. Without all the portal puzzles.
Alright.
That's the story. So, now you can return to the game.
Look up.